fellow collectors, and welcome to Long's Toys. Today we are taking a look at Niji Kagachi and Earth Garen Mod 2 unit from the Ultra Monster Advance series from Bandai. So as you probably know by now, the Ultra Monster Advance is kind of a supplement or kind of a subline of the Ultra Monster series that Bandai does, which is just the vinyl kaiju figures that they've been doing for years. But what makes them advance is they have a little bit more articulation than we're used to for the Ultra Monster series. So you can see this has like an extending tail segment, and these pieces around his head are able to rotate. So it's just a little bit more kind of souped up in terms of articulation than the usual vinyl figures. I haven't been buying many of these, but the reason I decided to pick this one up is because it comes with the Earth Garen Mod 2 unit, which is these kind of two gun pieces that he has, these shoulder cannons, which is a segment that you peg into his back, and then actually will unlock new sounds in Earth Garen, which is pretty cool. Not really sure why they decided to pack this in with this release instead of just with Earth Garen, but here we are. I guess it worked because it caused me to buy this. So as you can see here on the front of the packaging, nice big picture of the actual Niji Kagachi. Hopefully I'm pronouncing that correctly. And if I remember correctly, Niji Kagachi is the one that Blazer, I think, got the sword from, or he got some kind of power up. I haven't watched much of the show, but I know he got the stone for Niji Kagachi and it gave him a power up. He hasn't gotten many form changes, but he's gotten various kind of power ups throughout the series. So yeah, front of the packaging, pretty cool. Up here shows again the vinyl figure, and then, you know, it fighting Earth Garen now with the shoulder cannons. Over here on the side, I guess this is a clip from the show giving you a little bio here about Niji Kagachi, which is pretty cool. Over on this side, showing you how tall the vinyl figure is on its own, 155 millimeters, which I can't convert that. Taking a look at the bottom, showing you, I guess we have to connect the tail ourselves, so we'll do that. Spinning it around to the back, again, just kind of showing you some of the articulation, how you can connect these pieces to the Earth Garen figure. So yeah, pretty cool. I'm going to go ahead and get everything out of the box here, and we'll take a closer look. So here is Niji Kagachi out of the box. All you have to do is pop the tail on. It's really simple because it's kind of a softer material. You just kind of wiggle it on there and push, and then it'll eventually snap into place. And then you can see that it does rotate pretty nicely. Yeah, he's pretty large, honestly. 155 millimeters through the power of the internet, I found, is about 6 inches tall. So he is a pretty good size. And just for a quick comparison, here he is with Earth Garen. You can see that they're roughly the same size. I mean, if you're going to the top of these little horn pieces up here, about the same size. If you're going head to head, I'd say he's about an inch tall or something like that. So yeah, he's pretty cool. Articulation points, you do have again the swivel here in the tail. As one of the bonus features, you have the extendable tail here, and this can actually kind of rotate around as well. Pop that back in. You can rotate his legs, one solid piece here. The arms will kind of swing side to side, and then these pieces here will rotate down and kind of clip together and cover his face. Now, unfortunately, mine are a little warped just from being in the box because they are kind of thinner plastic, but they'll still connect together there. That's kind of cool, actually. I kind of like that look. Kind of has this cool face shield with the two horns. Maybe if I leave it like this, it'll kind of bend itself back into place. But yeah, I think that's pretty cool. Overall, it's a good-looking kaiju. Definitely larger than we're used to seeing with the Ultra Monster series. They've kind of scaled those down, and they're usually anywhere between like 4 and 5 inches. So this is definitely a larger figure. They do have like a deluxe size, and I would say this is probably closer to that, but I've seen some of those be even larger. Like here is one of the, this was a form of Belial, I think at some point, Arc Belial, I wanna say. This guy's obviously much larger. This was surprisingly expensive, but it looked so amazing, I had to have it. In any case, you can see that there's quite a size difference here. So it's kind of somewhere in the middle between the standard size and like the super deluxe size. But yeah, about 6 inches tall. Detailing, very nice. I mean, there's always a lot of molded in detail with these figures. Paint applications, pretty good, at least from the front. It's, I suspect this is supposed to continue all the way through this kind of shoulder pad here, and it just kind of stops about halfway. If you're familiar with vinyl dolls at all, that pretty much par for the course, where there's kind of an invisible vertical line about halfway where all of the paint stops. And you don't usually get a ton here on the back. But again, a ton of molded in detail. I mean, all these little spikes, these ridges, these plates, all of that kind of stuff, all looks really good. So even though they might not be painted completely, you know, the paint on the front always looks really sharp, and then just the amount of molded in detail is always very impressive. So let me pop these back up here so you can see that these are painted on the inside. You have a mixture of yellow and blue, and then the face is just really nicely painted. Let me zoom in here so you can see all of that detail. Really nice and sharp. Like I said, from the front, they always look fantastic. I mean, you have this black paint here to kind of bring out the details, the nice metallic red here, the red and gold here. You have a little bit of copper down here on the thighs. So all in all, you know, really, really looks sharp. I just wish the paint kind of continued on to the back, at least for the shoulder pads. I don't expect, like, the full back to be painted. But if we kind of bring the box back in just for a second, you can see here, like, from the show, that these are supposed to kind of be painted all the way. And it also kind of looks like they're supposed to be painted in between these ridges. And they didn't really do that here. They just kind of painted the ridges and everything. I understand that that's very... like, up here, you could probably accomplish it fairly easily, but it gets more meticulous as they get smaller and tighter together. But even if they had just painted it all the way across, just for the shoulder pads, I mean, I would have been perfectly fine with the thighs stopping there and the back being unpainted. I kind of just wish the shoulder pads continued on to the back. But again, not a huge problem. Still looks very, very good. So I'm pretty happy with this guy. I like all of his little features for a vinyl figure. Very nice and impressive size-wise. Pretty standard articulation with the tail spin, the arms. We even have the legs, which you don't always get, but I guess for the larger ones, they can put that in. And then you get the added little bit of the tail spike, and then the added little bit of the face guard popping down, which I think is really cool. I do really like that look. It does cover, you know, all that beautiful paint and face detail, but I do like the horns, and I kind of like the simplicity of it. I just think that looks kind of neat. It's almost kind of like a cow catcher or a battering ram that he can deploy to just kind of ram into enemies. So now here are the pieces that are included for Earth Garen. They attach very simply. They just peg into the side. So you can see it's just a very simple little peg and peg hole, and that just pops on. Now there's kind of a little shelf over here for this one, so you can't really move this around. But there is a point of articulation here so that this can move up and down like that. This one, because it doesn't have the shelf, you technically could move this at this joint as well, but also has that joint here to kind of click them up. It's almost like a little ratchet. It kind of clicks into one of the two positions. And these are pretty nicely painted. I mean, there's not a ton of paint, but I don't think it really needs it. But you have a little bit of silver there, a little bit of orange around the barrel here. This almost has like a chainsaw design to it, which is kind of neat. And then it has the connection points right here. So when we pop this onto the back of Earth Garen, this tab here is going to depress a tab on his back that will activate the new sounds. So I'm going to go ahead, bring in Earth Garen, and we can check out those new sounds. So here is Earth Garen. This is a separate figure that is completely sold separately. I did a review for this guy a while back. I'll put a link to that review at the end of this one. But yeah, he's pretty cool. I like him a lot. He's got a little button here on his belly. So that kind of, you know, makes sounds, lights up the eyes, the cannon in his mouth, all that I think is really cool. So you can see that there are two clasps or pegs, whatever you want to call these connection points here on the back. And then there's a little button inside that's going to get depressed when we go ahead and pop this on. So let's go ahead and connect this. There you go. So it announces that it's connected, and then we can cycle through some new sounds now.
Yeah.
I think we may have gone around fully, but yeah, so just some new sounds with the cannons and everything. A lot of the sounds are the same, kind of like stomping and things like that, but still very fun. If you hold it down there, you can get some growling sounds and whatnot. So really cool. I like this figure a lot. I love the lights and sounds. I think his eyes and the mouth cannon lighting up is really, really fun. And by connecting this to the back, one, you know, increases his look. He's now got the shoulder cannons ready for business, but also unlocks some new sounds, which I think is really great. I think this is a really fun release. I didn't buy most of these Ultra Monster Advance figures because I'm kind of just running out of room with the vinyl dolls. And the thing with Ultraman is a lot of times they use the same monsters year after year, so you can find yourself kind of buying repeats of the same Kaiju vinyl dolls over and over again. But I'm really glad I picked this one up because it's a very significant Kaiju to the series. Comes with the extra pieces for Earth Garen. You can see I think he's going into sleep mode there when the light flashes and then goes out. But yeah, so I just think this was a really good one to pick if you're not going to grab many of these. If you do have the Earth Garen figure, I think this is definitely one look worth looking into because, like I said, it's a significant Kaiju to the series. Looks great. I love the little added features, and I love the extra unit for Earth Garen because it kind of increases that figure. Plus, they just look great together. They scale well. You know, you can totally envision these two guys battling it out, and I think that's a lot of fun. So definitely recommend checking this out. I mean, if you're a fan of these, you know, there's definitely more in the series. I think they did at least four or five of them, maybe more. I wasn't 100% keeping up with them at the time. I kind of, like, after I found out that this piece came with this one, I kind of went and sought this one out. But like I said, glad I did. He's very cool. Like him a lot. My only real minor complaint with him is I wish for at least the shoulder pads that the paint continued for the entire shoulder pad. It would have been totally fine with the rest of the thigh not being painted, the whole back, all that. I'm totally fine with that. I'm used to it for the vinyl figures. But I do kind of wish that just at least the shoulder pad got the full treatment. But otherwise, he looks great. I mean, the face is really nicely painted. I like this horn, you know, shield mask feature that it has going here. Arm and leg articulation as well as the tail. And then the additional spike piece popping out. It looks kind of like a sword, which is kind of neat. So, yeah. All in all, a lot of fun as I knock Earth Garen over. Let's fix that. There we go. So yeah, very cool. Definitely recommend checking this one out, especially if you have the Earth Garen figure, because it is going to give you more playability out of that guy. So definitely one to check out. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Please like, share, and subscribe. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. And as always, thanks so much for watching.